What else for me? This is for me too? Ooh.
Open it.
Okay. Boys! Peanut!
What?
Shepherdsville neighborhood stunned, now looking for the answers to an unthinkable crime. Police say two young boys were killed by their own mother. Tiffanie Lucas was arraigned in court this morning, charged with two counts of murder, and she will be staying behind bars on $2 million bond.
So this is 32-year-old Tiffanie, Celine, and Lucas, a divorced mother of two precious boys, 9-year-old Jaden and 6-year-old Maurice, who Tiffanie always refers to as Peanuts. And on Wednesday the 8th of November 2023, around 11 a.m, this woman made the diabolical decision and shot to death her two sweet sons in their family home in Brentwood Drive, Shepherdsville, Kentucky, Tennessee. It seems to be in between a few areas, so I've just popped it on the maps here. The murderous mother was then seen by a neighbour walking from her front door and proceeded to pass out on the front lawn just after she delivered this line: "My kids are dying inside." That neighbour, then hoping it wasn't true, headed inside of the home and unfortunately came upon the two bloodied bodies of the young boys. The neighbour tried to render aid whilst waiting for help to arrive. Jaden and Maurice were rushed to Norton Children's Hospital. They both clung to life until, by 2:50 p.m., both boys had succumbed to their horrific injuries, inflicted by the one person meant to protect them from all danger, their mother. But why? Why would anybody do this? We're going to take a look into the life of Tiffanie and her two boys in this video today and speculate on why. Why this woman suddenly broke and did the unthinkable to her two innocent children. Tell me your thoughts in the comments. But some people are just pure monsters. Tiffanie is currently, as of this video being made, held at Bullitt County Detention Centre. She has so far appeared in court twice, first time via video link. The next day, where she appeared with her arms folded and a look of arrogance, not a hint of remorse, if you ask me. She then appeared in court on Tuesday, the 4th of November, in person, with just as much arrogance and still seeming unremorseful for her horrific actions. Thankfully, the judge rationally decided that Tiffanie remained a danger to the public, therefore her bond of $2 million would still stand. Apparently, family members had raised concerns to social services many times of worries of how Tiffanie was treating the children, yet not much more has been said about that. Tiffanie had been previously in jail for 30 days on a drug charge, but had no criminal record between 2018 and 2023. A friend who spent Halloween with A friend who spent Halloween with Tiffanie, Jaden and Lucas just days before the horrendous murders took place said she seemed to treat them wonderfully but suspected they saw a darker side of her as well. Like, what does that mean? Speculation? Observation? Because if you ever believe a child may be mistreated in any way, You must intervene and be that child's voice. Her friend also stated she goes off very fast. Again, like, what does that mean? If you see something, you act. So, what changed for Tiffanie, and why did this 32-year-old mother, who seemed to adore her children, suddenly, one day, murder them both? Well, let's take a little look into Tiffanie's life. What is her fucking name? Yeah, Tiffanie, why have I put Stephanie everywhere? Fuck's sake. Okay, I'm just going to say this right now. Because of my fibromyalgia, I get really confused. And throughout my story, I've somehow wrote Stephanie instead of Tiffanie all throughout my story. So I'm reading it as Stephanie. So I'm really sorry if I say that. A name is definitely Tiffanie. My bad. So let's carry on. So this is Tiffanie's, not Stephanie. This is Tiffanie's Facebook page where she calls herself Celine Tiffanie Anne. She has a picture of her two sons as a profile cover. And it states, J and Peanuts, world forever, with two heart emojis and two king emojis, obviously for Jaden and Maurice. Now let's look about her. So it doesn't show any workplaces or schools, but it does say that she lived in Louisville, Kentucky, and is from Chicago, Illinois. In details about Celine, she goes as far as to tell us just how to pronounce her name. Like, we don't know if or where you work, but we can pronounce your name. I'm pretty sure the majority of us can say Tiffanie and Lucas. And to be honest, you're really not that important. What I found most interesting was in family and relationships, she states that she is divorced. Not single, divorced. Now, that sends a message, in my brain at least, that she is disinterested in male attention. She loves attention in general, don't get me wrong. This is evident in her videos. But, to me this says, I'm not single, I'm divorced. As in, I've been through some shit and we don't need to go on a date for me to tell you I'm divorced. You can see for yourself. Usually, someone so young, especially still looking for a future partner, would just put single. And explain further when needed. She's outwardly and openly saying to everyone here, I'm not interested. I certainly see it this way. I look at things differently and deeper than others, and I think that this one open choice here actually says a lot. But she also does make a point about loving her sons throughout. While she also shares posts that clearly show a lot of things and feelings underneath. Like this post she shared, only in October, the 19th, so very recent to the murders, at 4:03 p.m, she didn't write this, but she shared it, and it said, sorry, but a BD, what is a BD by the way, I have no idea, sorry, but a BD can be bitter too, not helping financially because you and mum aren't on good terms, not helping physically with pickups from practices and daycare, not wanting to create a schedule for your kids, constantly trying to make things hard for the mom. Sorry, I hate saying mom. A pretty bitter and anger-filled post. Clearly aimed at one person. The child's father. There is only one. Even though Jaden and Maurice do not have the same father, unfortunately, Jaden's father had passed away. Well, actually, he was murdered around 4 years earlier. He was brutally shot and killed in the street. In what is still classified as an unsolved cold case. Tiffanie has shared posts for him on her social media, and it seems the death and loss did hit her hard, and was probably hard financially, and seeing her child without his dad, having to constantly explain things and why he was absent in his life and always will be. It seems from her posts and pictures and the dates with them that he passed around early July of 2019. I think her very first Facebook picture was back in October 2017. Of course, it's herself posing. Then shortly after, a photo of her and her boys. Then herself again. Then her and her boys. And yeah, there is a trend here. She poses a lot, but she also shares many photos of her and her boys as they grow up. With doing my research and going back to 2016 now, and before her Facebook, I came across Tiffanie on the news opening up her own shop, which just looked like a really shit corner shop, to be honest. And she named it Miss Tiff's, or Miss Tiff's. So inventive. I think it closed a year later after failure of a nearby Walmart opening slowed her sales down. Your shop was shit. Here is a little clip of her talking on the news.
Make their way down here, but if there's a Walmart, you know, you come out of the woodworks for Walmart. So probably would have brought a lot of people to, you know, stop and check us out.
Now I've taken the time to put together all of Tiffanie's Facebook videos from the start so we can have a little look through. I've also included most of the dates and views whilst keeping privacy of others. And obviously a lot of these views are going to be since the murders took place. These views, it's obvious, like she doesn't have even that many friends. These people have viewed the pictures and videos since the murders. And that's why on some of them there are so many views, especially the more recent ones. So let's have a look at Tiffanie's social media world, starting with mainly all videos of just her. I had to break it down for myself, but I have also put together videos of her and her boys afterwards. Some may be repeated, so please bear with me. Okay, so let's take a look at some of her videos. This one was in 2018.
What's up, y'all? We out here.
One of her first videos, well, that we can see anyway.
We're out here swimming. Me and the key.
Key.
What y'all doing? It's really nice over here. Well, me and my fat daddy.
What's up? God, I thought she dropped him, right?
He wants to go in the water.
My daughter is the worst.
Now I hit the FBO with duffels in my hands. I did have a Zen 13 hours till I land. Happy out like a light
day. You can hear the clack. It's funny. It's one of these stupid 2 second videos, I hate them. This is what she'd wrote next to this video. Hashtag heavyweight, hashtag dream girl. Don't know about that. Gosh, she loves herself. Oh no, not another 2 second video. Oh, get rid of it. Go. Rude. I keep thinking they're doing it when they're driving, but that's in England. In America, I don't think she's driving. She clicked again.
Y'all wish I was Billy, don't y'all? We 10 years in. He been holding me down.
That's a cute cup.
See ya.
Yeah, but he doesn't know what you're all about.
That's for me.
Oh gosh.
What
cuties.
Else for me? This is for me too? Ooh.
Open it.
Okay.
Oh, so sweet. Look how happy they are just to give their mum some flowers and a card for Valentine's Day. Having no idea what she was going to do to them. Oh, she's back. Excuse you. What the? Someone fart in the background. What the? He moved at the same time as everyone. Watch, watch. Watch. Oh, that's too good timing, though.
What's up?
Oh, that's a cute dog. 93,000 views, guys. I mean, come on, that's clearly since the movies.
Are you loving on me? What's a good morning? Me too.
That dog's amazing. Looks like his ears are being cut though, and I don't agree with that.
So when my dad was alive and would come visit me, I would always bring him here, and he loved it.
Oh, 221 views, guys.
Since I can't go all the way back up north, I'm releasing balloons for my dad. I love him so much, and I hope you have the best
Oh my god, she didn't even say Father's Day for the video. That's not annoying.
They didn't have Father's Day balloons, but I got a smile on my face because you always make me smile. And a flower because you always bought me flowers.
Is it just me or does a voice grind on anyone else?
Be grateful if your father is here. Be present in his life. Mend relationships. You never know. I watch my son struggle without his. And we struggle with our minds. Be grateful.
Wow. Be grateful. Be grateful for your kids. I mean, just listening to her talk like that, knowing what she's gonna do, what she's done. Oh, it's just awful. She's awful. 304 views, wow. Views.
Boys!
Boys!
Peanut!
Oh, he's so cute. See, they start they're dancing for it first, then she films herself and films other stuff. So they stop and then she's like, boys!
Boys! Peanut!
Well, they were dancing. He's dancing. Oh god, he's so cute. Oh, this one gives me the creeps every time, guys. This is like the second to last video ever. 153,000 views. The Mandalorian, Baby Yoda, and Princess Leia. I mean, that smile just really, when you know what she does. And this is the last ever video, guys. This stupid filter on her eyes. Look at that, eyelashes moving. Why did you always have to use filters on kids? 157 views, wow. See, these are the last pictures ever taken of Tiffanie and the boys. Look how she's just posing with them. Those eyes say way too much for me. Oh gosh, that is the last ever photo that she ever took with Jaden and Maurice. Oh, I just noticed both the boys' afros sticking out of their masks. Oh my god, they were so adorable. I mean, both boys look so sweet in the videos, whereas Tiffanie shows clear vanity in front of the screen and obviously finds herself attractive. That is evident to see. To be honest, some of the videos and photos are most probably being removed from Tiffanie's Facebook. I'm actually really surprised that her Facebook's still up, to be honest. They're usually taken down as far as I'm aware. She has not got tons of videos, but compared to selfies, she actually took and shared many more videos of herself with her children or just the boys. That doesn't mean that she didn't also share like a million photos of herself just posing in not much clothing at times, and also quite sexually in a few. She clearly lacks the attention. Just photos of her in general. She seemed to have quite an active life, whilst also showing her struggles, like with the loss of her son's father, and bitterness towards the surviving of the two. Tiffanie also lost her own father, John Lucas, which would obviously affect anyone at any age, and she would share loving photos with him. She had many of herself, but also took and shared many memories of Jaden and Peanuts. They also looked so happy and enjoying whatever they were doing, But as we all know, you can never believe what is being portrayed over social media or what is really going on behind closed doors, no matter the neighbourhood. So these are the videos of her and her boys now.
Are you walking? Are y'all shopping?
This one in 2018, I think this was the first video she put on of them. Well, that we can still see anyway.
Yay! Oh, whoopsie!
My heart beat at the night. After you know what she's done, and you see all these words she uses to describe them. Heartbreaking. Just annoying. This was actually the post that she put with that one. So she put, seriously, no one could understand the joy, love and meaning that these little kings bring to my life. I couldn't imagine a day without them. I don't even remember what life was like before them. They truly have given me purpose and shown me what genuine real love really is. A lot of times I feel like the only thing I'm good at is being a mother. I play zero games about them. Wow. Why did they do these 2 second videos? Makes them not look right. 2020 now, November. Oh, look at his little face. By the way, don't ever take your kids on bumper cars. It's not the worst thing you could ever put your kid at. Look how tiny he is. His body hasn't even grown yet. He's just getting slammed about. I had to cut this video, by the way, because I couldn't watch him slamming about. Plus, it was the longest one on there, and it's just the same thing, them going around. Oh, he's adorable. Celine's October. It's not even your name. Ugh. That food looked mangy. Okay, so there's some of the kids in there, but that was basically just selfies of me and that month. Laura's hair, it's mad. Wake the F up with a kiss. That's slightly passive aggressive.
That's for me.
Oh, what's this what video else for again me? In
this is for
February,
me too.
February, so Valentine's
Day. Ooh.
Open it. Oh, boys.
Okay.
Pure havoc. Get on.
Oh, I love when kids are into a game that much the day of me leisure there. Oh. She's got one of them stupid girl filters on that makes the boys look like girls. So he just ducks out of the way. Oh, why are you making me look like a girl again, mum? Put makeup on me. And she certainly does take them all.
JJ!
Take some places. Or took some places, shall I say. They're so funny and cute.
Y'all having a good time? What?
I just mix his brother's food. Oh, he's so cheeky. Oh, I want to go to one of these shows.
Whoa.
17,000 views. Wow. Okay, I have to cut the video here because I can't take the strobe lights, it makes me go really funny.
70 years later, 70 million years, and you guys are still hunting. Wait, a raptor? Oh, what is that called?
But it's this that's fire. Craft House Pizza with my name in. What is it?
A pancake.
A bus in, right, Pete?
Cheesy pancake, the cheese on the outside. Pictures. What's that? See, she certainly managed to take them many places and to fund the days out. Days out, I'd only dream of taking my niece or nephew.
Happy Easter!
6,000 views.
Tina is Spider-Man.
I mean, she seemed to make a fuss of them at all occasions.
Ooh, this is yours, Jaden. What do you think?
I like it.
What about you, P? No. Look.
I like it.
Okay.
Wait. I want.
Okay.
4th of July, I'm guessing. Yeah. Whoa. 116,000 views. Views.
Okay.
Wow. Defo since the murders.
Okay. Oh.
Wow, this one. 762,000 views. Wow.
Boys!
I'm amazed this Facebook
still.
And the last video, the video that gives me the absolute creeps with the music. 150,000 views. Just here at the end. Oh. And the very last video they ever had together. 154,000 views. Just that short little video. Last ever video together. Oh man, it's just so heartbreaking to see them both. Just enjoying life the way they should. Being young boys, brothers, besties, so sad. So what made this seemingly loving mother snap? Well, there had been signs. Obviously family members had not called social services for no reason, and apparently multiple times. So there was obvious worries on the boys' behalf. Yet they remained in the clutches of the one person who would flip and take both of their lives. She had shown bitterness in the recent post towards the child's living father and hinted at financial troubles. At least that's one big thing I noticed. Yes, she is bitter and he doesn't make a plan to pick up the kids, but a huge thing here is the word financial, as money is always a big reason that murder is committed in many ways, such as robbery gone wrong, murder for life insurance, money owed, or even just feeling they cannot financially move forward and afford the life they want for their children and themselves. And in some of these sick and twisted minds, they somehow believe murdering those innocent children is the best way out. There is always a better way out. I'm sure many family members would have stepped in to help. Maybe she didn't want that. Didn't want anyone else to have them, perhaps even the surviving father she is bitter towards. I just personally believe that she didn't want anybody else to have her children. It's like when people are in relationships and they murder the other person. Like the other video that I did about the young girl who met a boy on social media. She was from Canada, he was from England. She travelled over and he was obsessed with her. He didn't want anybody else to have her, so he murdered her. It's the same sort of thing, like, if I can't have them, no one can. We do know that Tiffanie spent time in jail over a drug possession charge, even though this was years before. Just because somebody does not get caught doesn't mean they are not committing an offence. They just haven't got caught again. And again, this is pure speculation and observation here, but I do think that in those last photos she posted, she seemed intoxicated. And when I say that, I don't mean by alcohol. To me, it's in the eyes. I know she has one of those filter things on and seems to have a lot of work done, but there is still something in those eyes. They seem glazed over, intoxicated with some kind of drugs. I just feel like, just from looking at the photos, I get that kind of feeling. Like, you can tell over the time of her photos, the way she's changed. There's something about the eyes. It's always in the eyes. Again, just speculation, but the family have also since said that they believe drug abuse was involved. That followed her more recent court appearance, so perhaps drug use was mentioned then. We may find out. Drug abuse can also obviously cause financial struggles, and depending, she could have easily got herself into money trouble over this. Who knows? She may have even had bad drug dealers after her. Sounds far-fetched, I know, but not really. It seems Tiffanie's aggressive ways may have been witnessed by others. The friend who has spoke out and said she goes off very fast also said she would flip a switch when mad. I mean, what is she inferring? As there is a huge difference between someone who may get aggressive when drunk, say, and somebody starts them first, compared to a parent who takes their anger and frustration out on their own innocent children. This following the release of an awful doorbell camera of a neighbour catching one mum doing the unthinkable to her son, kicking him and literally launching him down the concrete corridor of their apartment building, and she didn't know she was being watched. I mean, what was that woman doing behind closed doors if she was literally kicking him and dragging him through the concrete floor? I mean, it's so worrying, it's so scary. I literally could lose so much sleep over stuff like this. Anyway. So, is this what the friend may be inferring? That Tiffanie took her aggression out on the boys? Either way, her comments, plus the family members flagging up worries to social services, it clearly shows us that something wasn't right in that household. There may have been many reasons, but certainly no excuses for Tiffanie Lucas's horrific actions that Wednesday morning. A responding officer said, "It's part of the job. But it's the part of the job you dread, the part you hope you go your entire career and never see." But they did see. Two lifeless little boys, so much life left to live, taken, stolen, by the one person meant to protect them, their own mother. Now, Tiffanie claimed two ridiculous things. One, she apparently told responding officers that someone had given her a gun. Okay, like who? And why on earth would they, or did they? Also, she claimed that she was somehow manipulated into this murder through Facebook and Wi-Fi. What on earth could this possibly mean? Or is she just pretending to be insane now? I really can't accept that, sorry. And I don't think anybody else can either. Her family certainly couldn't. I have a feeling that her and her defence team are going to claim some sort of insanity or, you know, drug influence, like under the influence of drugs. But I mean, you can clearly see by the way she appears in court that there's no remorse. She also claimed the murders were an accident, but a neighbour's door cam actually captured the sounds of at least 4 gunshots in the space of 30 seconds. So how many times can you accidentally shoot both of your children? Because you're claiming at least 4. In 30 seconds. I mean, think about that, you know. You press the trigger and, oh my God, like, what have I done? At least 4 times in at least the span of 30 seconds. That is no accident. It was obviously no accident. This was a clear execution of 2 innocent little boys. You know, it's strange how people like this hardly ever harm or kill themselves, just the innocent children or other family members. Tiffanie was heard shortly after the murders by responding officers saying, "I'm in such a bad spot." Yeah, now you are. Also, "I'm so stupid." Yes, you are. And this strange and perhaps pre-planned statement, "I would have never done anything like this unless someone else manipulated me." What like Wi-Fi? You might hear something like this later on, like in court or an interrogation, but not immediately after the crime is committed. And how could someone manipulate you to do that anyway? I'm sure much more will come out soon. Since the tragic event and Miss Lucas's arrest, family members have said to have cleared out the Bullitt County home where the double murders were committed, which they described as filthy. It also appeared that the utilities had been turned off, which usually is due to a lack of payments met. So obviously financial troubles. And as I had previously guessed, it seemed she was not doing as financially well as she had portrayed in her Facebook pictures and videos, as an eviction notice had also been found on the county. I knew it was to do with money. I generally felt an eviction must have been imminent. Although it is unthinkable to imagine a mother murdering her children because of an eviction notice, but I've seen it too many times. Similar to another video I covered, Joseph Parker and the body in the freezer, where he murdered his wife because of the financial burden after 12 loving years married. But money is never a reason to murder. Tiffanie Lucas remains on a $2 million bond, and next time she appears in court will be in front of a grand jury. If you ever believe you see, hear or know anything about child abuse, children being abused, anything like that, you must speak out. Children need a voice. Be that voice. Thank you for watching my video today. I am sure a lot more will come out of this soon, and I'll probably do a follow-up video at some point as well, seeing what else we find out in court. It's taken me a while to put this one together, actually. I started it pretty much straight away, but it's just been a lot of getting everything together, and I ended up doing the other two videos, and the drunk teacher turns up to court drunk, and then the most drunk driver I've ever seen. I ended up doing those two videos in the middle of this one. To be honest, I start a lot of projects and end up just not finishing them. I've got quite a few murder documentaries I'm like halfway through, and you know, I just end up giving up, and that's a big part of my health problems. So I'm trying my best for you guys, trying to give you some good videos, and hopefully you're enjoying them. Thank you everybody who's been subscribing and watching my videos. It honestly means so much to me, and I'll see you soon. Random Jen.